Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to Will's Garage. Today we're working on a 2011 Audi A4 with the 2-liter turbo TFSI motor. Customer brought it in. Mostly just because they're worried about the timing tensioner that's really common to go bad on these. Nothing else wrong, but we're going to do a full timing tensioner. We're going to do all three chains, the main cam chain, the intermediate chain, and the oil pan chain, as well as all the guides. So, a lot of this video might be a little boring in between with basic assembly, disassembly stuff like the service position, pulling silly covers off, the belly pan, which I'm currently working on, which is fairly easy. And again, I'm on a lift, so it's much easier. But this is still a repair you could do in your driveway. Don't need many special tools. I know there is one special socket for the cam phaser. So depending on how far you're going with the job, you may need that tool or you may not. Like if you are just replacing the tensioner and you're leaving the chains in place, you probably don't need that tool. Just make sure you do your measurements afterwards to make sure the timing is correct, because nobody likes to have to do the job twice. But we are going to do the full timing chains with the tensioner. There was one other thing I wanted to say, and now I forgot. So, anyway, let's get to it. Okay, guys, just quick update. I've got the car in service position. And as you can see, front bumper's off. Well, the front bumper cover, rather. The core support. A bunch of electrical connections, really just unplugged. On the A4, it actually pivots. Let me see if I could show it. Pivots on these brackets. I don't know if you can see them. A bracket right there. There's another bracket right here. So you can get the thing to swing out of the way, but not have to remove it fully. The way I have it right now, I don't have to remove coolant. Although I did have to remove the return line from the top of the coolant bottle. This is pretty much how far you need to go just to get to the front of the engine to get to the timing covers. You're gonna have to remove the serpentine belts, the top engine cover, the lower engine cover, which is gasketed with silicone. I believe Volkswagen Audi now use a Loctite brand. It's like a black sealant. So the next things I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the serpentine belt. I'm going to remove the upper and lower cover, including the harmonic balancer, which I'm going to set top dead center first. That way everything is at least close to where I need it to be for timing chains to get everything set. Even though the chains, which I am using factory chains, have either colored chain links or some kind of marking on the chain so you can line it up. And again, I'll go through the procedure to show you the measurements. I forget the number off the top of my head, I'll have to look it up, but there's a certain amount of millimeter distance between the two cams. And different alignment marks that we need to line up on the intermediate shafts and stuff like that. So hang tight, we'll get this thing going. Okay, this is the inside of the motor. You can see the top timing chains. You can see the girdle, and there's that special bolt you need a special tool for. I have it currently set to time top dead center. That's the tensioner that's in question. Audi Volkswagen had a lot of issues with them. But you can see the intermediate chain like this. Drives the water pump shaft. You can this one here is the oil pump chain. And there's your guides. You can see they're all made of like a nylon plastic. And here's the other guide, or a tensioner rather, and then the other tensioner guide. So, next step, I'm going to remove the girdle. I'm going to remove all the chain components and start putting a new chain in. Alright, you can see here, I'm just trying to clean all the parts on. This is the lower timing cover. You see a lot of it gets really dirty just from oil changes and dropping the way the oil filter is, making a little bit of a mess. This one is, you know, somewhat extra dirty, but we'll clean it all out and put new bolts in it. We'll check the condition of the seal. If it needs to be replaced, we'll replace it. But it's always good practice to make sure everything's clean, especially when you take the engine apart like this. Okay, quick update. Just got the cam girdle off. And right away I noticed, let's see if I could show you here, and then my light is kind of messing things up. But right there, you could see the screen, you know, capture debris and stuff for the oil passage. And it has actually blown out and clogged the oil passage. And that screen comes from this spot right here on the girdle itself. So this is a real common issue, and more the reason why if you're replacing the tensioner, you should also remove all of these components. Also, real quick, this is the tool. So you can see what it looks like. I'll put the part number in the description of the video so you can see, but you will need this tool as long as the normal triple squares to get everything else apart. Okay, this is all the timing components removed. There's the intermediate shafts and everything. So obviously we're going to start with the intermediate shafts and balance shaft and then work our way back up. Just want to point out, it'll show in the video, but the timing marks you want are on the back gear there. Try to spin it. See the yellow mark I've painted, and then there are two little dots on the back helical cut gear. Don't go by this mark here. It's the back dots you want. Should be two, one on each side of that yellow mark I've made. And then the other mark on this one is there, which will line up with the chain. The other thing I wanted to point out is, if this is the first time you're doing one of these newer 2 liters, you could see the crankshaft has this almost like a triangle shape to it, with a small flat relief on the one side. It's very important that when you put the gear on, you make sure everything is meshing right. Otherwise your timing will be way off. You can either damage the engine or it will run poorly and just throw the check engine light. So keep that in mind when you put the gear on and you start putting everything back together to get it timed up. Okay guys, quick update. I just want to try to show you guys some of the other marks. Like I was discussing before, for the balance shafts and the water pump shaft chain. It can be a little confusing. I'll try to show you some of the slides from ELSA so you can get a grasp of what you need to do to line everything up and to get the chains where they need to be. So let me try to show you here what I'm talking about. Now, on the new factory chain, there's actually quite a bit of marks. You got a copper link here, you've got a darker link there, here, there's a double dark link here, and one there. So starting from the crankshaft, you could see we're going from this arrow. So there's your one link. The other one is going to that mark, which I highlighted with some white paint, and the other one here. And also, like I said, keep in mind that you need to make sure that this shaft here, the single dot lines up with the double dots on the helical. That way you know everything's timed. So assuming, like I said, the crankshaft sprockets are in that little flat notch,
and all your timing marks here line up, you should be good. So the next step, I'm going to start putting all the chain guides back on here, as well as the tensioner, and then we're going to work to get the upper chain back on. Just a quick note here, guys. All the tensioner and guide bolts you see here, it's not required, but I like to put a little bit of blue Loctite on those. So before you do that, make sure you clean up all the oil residue that might be on them, as well as in the holes that they go into on the block. I like to use Brake Clean, and then a little compressed air dries them up really nicely. And just a dab of Loctite will do. You don't want to overdo it. And again, blue Loctite, so that when this is being serviced again down the road for whatever reason, they can be removed. Okay, here's the chains on. You can see the top mark on the exhaust. There's the top mark on the intake cam. Hard to see if I can get it. There's the mark for the crankshaft. And again, make sure that all the intermediate marks still line up, because there is another special tool which is supposed to lock these guys into place, which I do not have. And as you can see, I don't really need. It's just tricky to hold the camshafts, because when you do have them in their time position, they are opening one of the valves, I'm not sure which one, so you're underneath that valve spring tension. So you can see I have all the lower guides for the intermediate shaft on right now, but I don't have the tensioner in. So I'm going to put all the other guides for the main chain on now, as well as the tensioner. And then I'm going to put the guide on for the oil pump chain itself. Okay. Here it is with everything assembled, aside from the cam bolt here and then the hydraulic bolt, actuator, adjuster, whatever it is. This weird guy there. All the marks are lined up, all the guides and tensioners are on. Now you can see I still have the pin in the main hydraulic, and I don't have the lower hydraulic tensioned. Same with the oil pump. Guide tensioner. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to remove all the tensioner clips, verify all the timing marks are still correct, and rotate the engine twice to make sure everything cools freely, nothing is interfering. You can see I have the bolt in here to hold the sprocket on the crankshaft. Like I said, you want to make sure that thing is seated perfectly. Want it to be offset, otherwise your timing will be, and you run the risk of damaging the engine. Okay, at this point I'm ready to put the silicone on that lower cover. Make sure everything is tight, all these are tight, all your guides, everything, tensioners are released, so everything's under tension now. I'm going to leave this bolt in the meantime so everything stays where it needs to be, but just make sure everything is clean, especially in these corners, because they're going to be prone to leak, and you want a little bit extra in there, and that's about it. Just wanted to show the amount of silicone. Don't need much, because what squeezes out is also squeezing in, and that is not good for anybody. See the little extra I have in the corners there. A little bit extra down there as well. So again, make sure everything is tight, all the tension is released, and time to put everything together.
Clockwise! Clockwise!
I'm sorry.
You did it!
Did I do it?
You did it!